Hi DIYers, Sterling here with Alarm Grid, and today we're going to show you how to program a 5820L Honeywell wireless slimline transmitter. So the 5820L is a door or a window contact. It can really be used on any opening. It says here that it's ideal for casement and double hung windows, which might have a skinnier frame. If we open up this sensor, we can show you that unlike the 5816, which is bigger and boxier, or unlike the 5811, which is nice and thin off the wall but has a wider footprint, the 5820L has this nice skinny frame so that if your window frame was very small, this would sit nicely without overlapping. This device includes some mounting screws, some double-sided tape, and it has your magnet for your sensor. Of course, it also has a battery. We have a AAA Energizer lithium. And basically, the device consists of the contact and the magnet. On one side of the sensor, you have two hash marks. On this side, they're not there, and of course, not on the short edge either. So when you have this mounted, you want your magnet to be on the side with the two hash marks. When the door or the window is closed, the sensor is happy. When the window slides up or the door opens, the magnet's pulled away from the sensor, and we have our fault or our alarm activation if the system is armed. So the first thing we need to do before we program this device is to pop it open and insert the battery to give it power. So not on this side, but on one of the shorter edges, there's this little tab, and using our screwdriver, we can pop the cover off. To get to the inside of the sensor, so we can insert our battery and give this unit power so we can program it. This tab can be a little tricky, so just kind of pry in and wiggle it until it pops. This back plate, we have our serial number. It's going to be hard to see in the video, but the barcode is showing with an alpha number 0980737. We have our cover with our circuit board, we have our battery contacts, we have our tamper switch, which would indicate if the cover is popped, that's a push button, which is held down when the cover's on. We have our model number 5820L, and we have our date code of when it was manufactured. To give it power, we need to insert our battery, and on the circuit board, there's a big plus imprinted to show you which side is the positive contact. So you insert your battery negative to negative, positive to positive, and we now have power for our 5820L. We can close it up. There's a little hinge. It basically is a little tab here that locks in there. Make sure that we're getting our sticker so it goes inside, and we simply snap it shut. The same serial number is on the back so that we don't need to have that sticker on the inside when we do our programming. We have our magnet and our powered up sensor, and we're ready to enroll our 5820L sensor. So the first thing we do from the home screen is hit security, then more, and tools. From tools, we use 4112, which is the default installer code, and gets us to this screen where we can select program to jump into system programming. You see right now it says ready to arm chime. As soon as we hit program, it says system programming, letting us know we're now in programming. If we go to zones, that's where we use the screen to select the next available zone. We go to zone 9 and click edit. And now we can input this device to the system. To learn in any Honeywell sensor to the system, you need the serial number, or you can auto-enroll the device. For our purposes, we do have the serial number, but we'd like to verify the sensor works and make sure that the proper serial number and the proper loop number get learned in. To do that, we can simply activate the device 3 times. To activate a door contact or a window sensor, we simply put the magnet next to the 2 hash marks, the side of the sensor that it needs to have the magnet, and we pull it apart. Activation number 1, you heard the panel beep, and now we go and close the door again. If this is mounted on your door, you know, you would simply be opening and closing your door. If you're doing it on the bench test, you simply fault the sensor by putting the magnet close, pulling it away, That's number two. We can see now we have loop number one, which is the proper loop when enrolling a 5820L. We have the verified serial number, which matches the serial number on the device, 0980737. And then we do one third and final activation. And that enrolls the device to the system and takes us to our zone screen. On this screen, this is where we have to select the parameters to tell the system how to respond to inputs from this device. First thing we want to choose is, are we going to put this on a door or a window? In our case, we have some double hung windows and we do have the skinny frame. We didn't quite have enough frame width for a 5811, so we're going to use the skinnier 5820L. And because it's going on a window, we choose device type window. Once we're on device type, we can select our response type. Typically with a window, you're always going to want the perimeter response, but there's other options you could use if you're going to vent your window or you wanted it to not alert a full siren, but you want it to hear chime. So you have some options here, but in our case, if the window opens and the system is armed, we want an alarm, we want a perimeter response type. 90% of door and window sensors, or 90% of window sensors are going to get that perimeter response type. Then we want to do zone descriptor 1, and we're going to name which window in our home is going to be used for zone 9. So if we have multiple window contacts in the house, instead of just naming them all window and having to remember that zone 9 is the living room window, zone 10 is the family room window, and so on, we can select and name the particular window. In this case, we're going to put it in our master bedroom.
Machine.
By hitting the M letter, it takes us to the library, the first M word. We can use the down arrow to cycle and choose each additional word until we get to master bedroom, or we can simply type
machine, master,
and we get to master. One more designation
master
down
bedroom
gives us the full master bedroom as one zone descriptor. We could have left it master and put in zone descriptor 2 as bedroom, but by putting it in this way, in case we had more than one master bedroom window, we could say master bedroom front window, master bedroom back window, or any other qualifying word which would give us a better designation of which sensor is which inside the master bedroom. So, for our case, we only have one master bedroom window. We're going to leave it as this. Alarm report, this is a toggle, yes or no. Yes means send this alarm to the central station. No means sound the audible alarm in the house, but don't send the signal through to the central. We are monitored, and we do want them to respond to this zone, so we're going to set it to yes. And then chime is disabled by default. On a window, I would prefer to know when the window's open, and therefore, you can highlight the chime sound that you want for when this window is open. We have it set to standard. You heard the beep, beep, beep. When this window's open in the disarm state, it'll be beep, 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 master bedroom window. So we have that beeping chime as well as the spoken words of the fault of the zone, and then that way we know when our windows are opening. Supervision should always be supervised for any protection zone, any intrusion device. Supervised simply means that the panel will check and make sure the device is being seen by the panel, and it will do that check every 12 hours. It would indicate a supervision trouble if the sensor was too far from the system or there was interference that was causing the wireless signal not to be reaching out to the sensor, or if something happened to the sensor where it broke, you know, and it wasn't being seen by the panel, this supervised would alert us to that issue as soon as possible. So we save it and we exit to the home screen. And to make sure that we did everything properly, we simply fault the device, open the door or the window, and make sure that the panel responds accordingly. So we have it on our window. Typically, you would have the sensor on the frame and the magnet on the movable window portion. So we slide our window up.
Master bedroom window.
And you can see the panel beep, beep, beep chimed. It also spoke master bedroom window and showed us this visual fault indication that the window's open. If you ever came to your system and you saw this and you were trying to arm the system, it's alerting you, hey, you have an open zone, go close it. So slide the window back down, magnet's back in line with the two hash marks. Now we can arm our system. So that is how you would program a 5820L wireless slimline door contact, window contact, to your LynxTouch L5200 system. We hope you enjoyed our video. We invite you to subscribe to our channel. And if you have any questions on the 5820L programming or the LynxTouch L5200 system, we invite you to email us support@alarmgrid.com.